गुड आफ्टरनून एवरी वन. माई सेल्फ हर्षल त्रिवेदी. आई एम करंटली वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन हसमुख गोस्वामी कॉलेज अहमदाबाद. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर यू स्टडीड अबाउट द बेसिक थियरीज ऑफ सी. टूडे आई वुड लाइक टू कवर द फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ सी प्रोग्रामिंग, दैट इज डेटा टाइप, कॉन्स्टेंट्स एंड वेरिएबल. नाउ दिस वुड बी द बेसिक लुकआउट ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन. फर्स्ट वी लर्न अबाउट सी टोकन्स, देन कॉन्स्टेंट्स, देन डेटा टाइप्स, देन वेरिएबल्स, देन ऑपरेटर्स एंड एक्सप्रेशन. Now, before moving forward, I would like to tell you what is the basic thing that a programmer needs to understand. The basic thing when we program anything, if we take example of C, now C is a programming language. Now, what each and every user wants, what we are concerned with, if you are developing something, then the basic thing is we require what kind of output we get. Means everything revolves around the output, what an end user wants. So a developer needs to develop a program in such a way that what kind of output he gets. So if we take, then basic, there are three things in the output which a user gets, that is a character, a number, or a string. As you can see over here, a character, number, and a string. If we take output, it would be either, it would be between 0 to 9, it would be A to Z, or it would be a combination of characters. So these are the three basic things that any programmer needs to keep in mind before making any program. So if these three things are clear, then you can develop your logic very easily, and in a very precise way you can do your C programming. Now, what is C made up of? Now, if you want to write any program, a basic program, we want to print anything, we want to print hello, we want to print our name, then first we need to understand that what is C made up of. The first thing is C tokens. Now, what is a token? If we split this word into two parts, one is C and another is tokens. C is a programming language, and token means, the basic meaning of token is, it is the smallest individual thing. Now we are talking about C program, so it is the smallest individual thing which we write inside a program. Now there are basically six types of tokens. First is keywords, next is identifier, then there are constants, then there are strings, there are special symbols and operators. Now what is all this? When we write any C program, then these are the different six things on which a program revolves around. Means if we are making any program, then these things are involved. Now what are keywords? Keywords are the words which are inbuilt in C. What are identifiers? Identifier is any name which we give in a program is an identifier. What are constants? If you are defining any value like 10, 19.20 as written in the slide, they are known as constants. What is a string? String is a collection of characters. Next is special symbols. We are using curly bracket, round bracket and everything. These are special symbols. And operators, we'll look everything in detail. Now first is a keyword. Now any C word is either keyword or an identifier. If we write anything in C, if we write any program, right? In the last lecture you know about you printed some basic hello, or you printed your name, as the Satvik sir told you. Now here, any word you write is a keyword or an identifier. Keyword is a fixed and cannot be changed. Keywords are fixed in C. Fixed means they are inbuilt in C, and there are various 32 types of keywords. If we look at the programming, when we write anything in C, if it appears in a white, it is a keyword. And we can't use that keywords in our programs. We can use that keywords to write a program. We can't use the keywords inside a program in declaring a variable or a constant. Now what are the different types of keywords? Now these are the basic different types of keywords. I have listed out something: auto, double, integer, struct, break, anything. If we are making a loop, if we are making a statement, if we are making a condition statement, if we are declaring integers, right? Then anything we are doing, they are basic inbuilt keywords in C through which we can do programming very easily. So this is a basic concept behind keywords. Now next is identifier. Now what is an identifier? Identifier can be referred to as any name in a C program. Other than keywords, if we write anything in a program, other than keywords and functions, then they are known as identifiers. Everyone might be heard about variables in C. Now what are variables? Variables are kind of identifiers. If we write integer A, now what is integer A? A is known as an identifier. Over here I have given an example that integer total. Now what is total? Total is known as an identifier. Integer is a data type which we'll look further in the presentation. Now there are some rules and regulations to declare any identifier. Now what are the rules and the regulations? Identifier means the name which a user can give. any name other than keyword is an identifier. Means a user gives a particular name is known as identifier. So what are the rules to write an identifier? The rules are, the first character should be alphabet, means it can't be an integer value. This is the first rule. Second is, keywords are not allowed in the identifier, means the basic keywords which I shown over here, if we use these keywords as an identifier, then they are not allowed in C programs. Then white space are not allowed. White space are not allowed means, if we are declaring an identifier or a variable, if we write integer a space a, or if we write in the example given over here, it's integer total. If we split the total in two parts and if we give a white space in between to and tal, then white space are not allowed. Second is, the identifier must consist of only letters, digits and underscore. No special characters are allowed. A special character which is allowed is only a underscore. Next is, the length should be maximum 31 characters. The length should not be more than 31 characters of an identifier. Means if we are declaring a variable integer a, then if you are writing a, then it can't be more than 31 characters. So these are the basic set of rules which we need to keep in mind before declaring anything in C other than keywords. The next are constants. Now what are constants? Now if we take a example of an identifier, then I'll just let you know that what are identifiers. I'll show you later. Now what are constants? Constants are basically, if we are giving some constant value to anyone, then this is known as constant value. And what are the basic constant types? That no constant can be two types, as we discussed in the first slide, that everything revolves around character and integer. If you want to do any programming, it's either a number or a character. So a numeric constant. Numeric constant consists of integer constants and real constants. Now what are integer constants? Integer constants are the constants which are without the decimal space, means like 100, 300, plus, minus, any value. Now what are real constants? Real constants are the constants which has decimal values. As we can see over here, there are 200.203. Now 200.203 is a real constant. Now what are character constant? Character constant consists of two parts. One is a single character constant and second is a string character. A string means, single character means we can write A to Z anything in a single quote which we write is known as a character constant. Let me make you clear, if we are writing a C program, if we are declaring any integer, means if we are giving any constant value, if it's a numeric value, then it is written directly, means integer A equal to 100. If we are using a string, a character, then characters are in a single quote. I'll show you later. And if you are using a string, then string are in double quotes. After character constant, there are string constant. Now what is a string? String is a collection of characters. So it is inside a double quote, as we can see in the example over here. Now next is special symbols and the operators. Now what are special symbols? When we are using curly braces, when we are using round braces and all this, and using square braces, they are all special symbols which are used in programming. So when you will learn about the programming, you will come across all these notations. And what are operators? Operators are plus, minus, multiplication and all, division and everything what we do. Means if we are doing computing anything, means if we want to do computation, if we want to apply our logic, then what we do? We'll use some or the other operator to write our logic. If we are writing a logic, operators are required. Means we are doing addition of two variables, we are doing subtraction, we are doing division or multiplication, then operators are required. Later we'll study that in detail, what are different types of operator. There are basically 9 or 10 types of operator in C. So the basic part is C. What we discussed about, there were C tokens. C tokens were keywords that we discussed, which are the inbuilt things. Then we discussed about identifiers. Then we discussed about identifiers, then we discussed about constants, then we discussed about strings, then we discussed about special characters, and then we discussed about the operators. Now, next is, what is a variable? The most important part in C is a variable. Now, what is a variable? If we want to apply any logic, it is compulsory to declare a variable. Or else, other than variable, we can print our name and everything. If you want to apply any logic, then variable is the base thing that we need to declare. So what is a variable? Variable is a name that will store a value. Variable is a name that will store a value. In what type of value a variable will be stored? A variable will store a value of a specific data type. What are data types? We will discuss later. Means a specific data type if we give, then variable will store a, if we are giving a data type integer, then the variable will store a value of a specific data integer value. If we are using a character, then it will use a it will store a character value. Now there are the same rules which we discussed in the identifier in slide number 6. The same rules and regulations are applied to declare a variable. This was all about variable. If we take an example, when we write a program, we declare a, b, x, amount, anything what we write is a variable. Now I discussed about various rules. Now these are all valid variables. As given in the example 1, all are valid variables. A, b, x, y, amount, total, GTU, etc. are all valid variables. Now what are invalid variables which we declare? Because variable is the most important part. So the next first is 1, 2, 3. Now what were the rules were? It should not start with a numeric value. Here it is starting with a numeric value. So this is an invalid variable name. Next is percentage. We can't use a special character other than a symbol. We are using percentage over here. So it's an invalid. Next is a combination of, it is an alphanumeric number. It's a numeric and a character, both are there, but it starts with a numeric, so we can't use that, it's an invalid. Next is integer. Now integer is a basic keyword of C, so we can't use integer as a variable. Character 4, then these are all keywords. Now last is G space TU. Now I have put a white space in this, so we can't use a white space in this, so it is an invalid variable. If you go through the exams and aptitude exams and all, this type of questions are mostly asked, that what are valid variables, what are invalid variables. They will give you a set of variables. They would contain half mark, one mark questions, which would be there in a paper. So these all are invalid variable names. Now what are data types? As we discussed earlier, a variable will store a value of a specific data type. Now what is data type? Data type defines the storage representation. What a data type defines is the storage representation, means what type of value should be stored. It is given in a data type. Next is, it will tell what type of value should be stored in a variable. Now what are the basic data types? The basic data types are character, integer, long, short, float, double, everything are basic. They are basic data types in C. Now according to various data types, they have various ranges. If we take a character, then character stores 1 bit. And the range is -128 to 127. If we take example of integer, then it will store 2 bytes in the memory, and the range is -32768 to +32768. So we can't store a value above this range. If we want to store a value above this range, then we need to use another data types, which is resemble these are higher data types than integer. There are floats, double, long double. These are all other data types which we can use. Now in the data types, there are basic two parts. So if we take basic data type, then they revolve around two things. One is integer, one is character. If we take float, long, double, what are these? Are extensions of integer. If we want to put a higher value than integer, then we use all these other data type. If we combine all the characters, then it becomes string. So everything revolves around character and integer. Now in the data type, there are basic two parts. One are signed and unsigned. Now there is no basic distinction. If we don't declare anything, if we don't specify signed or unsigned, then by default they are signed. Means we can store a value negative also and positive also. If we declare an unsigned data type, means unsigned character, then we can store, we can't store a negative value. It would be 0 to 255, as you can see. If we write unsigned integer, then it would be 0 to 65,535, means a negative value would be added into the positive value, and we can store the value from 0 to 65,000 something. Now next is how to use these data types. Now these data types are basically divided into three parts. One is primary, other is derived, and third is user defined. If we take further, it is primary data type, it is derived data type, and user defined data type. What are primary data types? Over here it is written primitive data type. Primitive data type means they are the basic data types. Now what are the basic data types? These are characters, integers, floats, double, void. These are basic data types. What are derived? Derived data types are data types which are from the primitive data type, but which are extension of a primitive data type. Means a array. What is an array? Array can be of two kinds. One is an integer, other is a character. An integer array can store more than one values. If we declare a single integer, an integer total, then we can insert only one value in total. But if we declare an integer array, we can store 5 to 6 values, 10 values, 20 values, what kind of array we give. A character. Character can store a single character. But if we use a character array, we can store a string. Other is functions, other is pointers. These are derived, means these are derived from the primitive data type. Means the base of all these data types are the primitive data types. Next is user-defined data type. Now, user-defined data types are the data types which are defined by a specific user. First is enum. Next is structure and union. This you will study in the further chapter. So, these are the basic distinction that in what categories the data types are divided. Means last we saw was the basic data type. Means these are the data types. Now, this is the distinction of the data types. Distinctions are in primitive, derived and user-defined. Everything depends on the primitive data type, means all other are the extension of primitive data types. Next is, if you want to use a data type, then there are basic format specifier of the data types. So what are the basic format specifiers? If we are using an integer data type, then if you want to print an integer variable, right, then the format specifier to use that is %d. If you want to use a short data type, then the basic is %d. If we are using a long data type, then to print a long value, it is %ld. If we are using characters, if we are giving a data type name character z, then if we want to use that, it is %c. For float, it is %f. For double, it is %lf. So these are the basic format specifiers. When we go through programming, I'll show you that how we can use all these things. Now see, I've given a basic example. Now, how to use a data type